Hi everybody, today I'm going to start a painting on a little 9x12 canvas right here. And I just wanted to mention, I'm an Amazon influencer now, and you can find all of this stuff at amazon.com/shop/Carl Mazur. And I will put a link to that in the video. But today I'm going to be using some stir sticks. I have some little push pins here, some 16 ounce cups, some Liquitex pouring medium, just some regular water. And I have some Amsterdam acrylics right here. One of them is called, what's that called? Violet. And this one is called Rose, Crichton Rose. And that one's called, that's Artist Loft Old Gold. And I'm gonna use some just flow acrylic by Artist Loft White. And I might use some Flood Floetrol in there. I know you can't find that in some countries. Just look under paint conditioners. Okay, let's get started. All right, I'm so excited for today's painting. This is the first time I'm ever going to attempt to try a tree ring pour. And I'm going to do it with the Liquitex pouring medium. So let me get started with some of these push pins. Because we use these push pins, and that way it keeps your canvas up off the plastic, because otherwise it will stick to the plastic and you'll never get your painting off of there. Some ladies have mentioned to me before, and guys too, to use, you can find bigger push pins, like big ones with big knobs on them, on Amazon. But again, you can go to amazon.com/shop/Carl Mazur and find all the products here that I'm using today. You don't even have to leave your home. You can just click a button. Okay, so I'm gonna start off with some of these cool colors here. I wanna start off with this red, but first I need to put in my pouring medium. Let me make sure it's shaken up good. If I can get the cap off. And I ran out of cup, so I had to use a little cup that I had extra. It's time to go order some more cups. Make sure the cap's on there tight. Okay, so now I'm ready for the dark paint. And on my Amazon site, I have the big craft sticks and I have the little craft sticks too. I just love the Liquitex pouring medium. It mixes and adheres and binds with the paint so good. I know it's more expensive to use, but man, it is so fun. And this pink color, I really wanted it to pop, so. So I'm trying to get as contrasty as I can with some dark color and then some really bright pink. And then white, and then I want to offset with some gold. I don't know how that's going to look, but we'll see. I hope everybody out there is doing awesome. I hope you're having a great day. Okay, time for the old gold. The old gold. It's not new, it's old gold. So this is old. And see how the right in there kind of starts to chunk up a little bit. But that's what I love about the Liquitex pouring medium. If you keep stirring it up, it helps take that out, those chunks. Because sometimes metallic paints will get lumpy on you. And you don't want lumps in your paint. So the consistency of that, you can see how it's pretty runny so far. So that's good. I don't want it too runny, but this pump on here doesn't work, so I've been having to take this out. Whoops. Put that back in carefully. And if you notice, I got cut on my arm here. It looks like I've been cutting myself. I caught my drone. I fly a drone and I caught, it started to land weird and all of a sudden it just went meow and I caught it and the blades went off right on my arm and me and my wife were laughing so hard as I was a bloody mess. She's laughing over here. Oh man. I was like, well, that didn't go as planned. I guess I'm done flying the drone for today. All right, so that's looking pretty cool. So we won't have to add much Floetrol at all to these. In fact, I'm not even sure. Yeah, maybe just a little bit. Just a tiny bit. The white was a little bit thicker, so I poured a little bit more Floetrol into there. And the water, sometimes I use water, sometimes I don't. I really want to try and stay away from using as much water as possible. I think I have way too much paint for this small painting, but I can always use it for another one. I just didn't know how much to use for my tree ring pour. I've never done one before. I really like these big craft sticks. You can mix a lot faster. Okay, let me set my paint to the side here. And I'm gonna start out with a dark color first. Then I'm gonna go white. Then I'm gonna go pink. Then I'm gonna do the gold. It's already starting to look really cool. Then I'm gonna go back to the dark. Okay, and man, I should have my rubber gloves. I don't have my plastic gloves with me. So I'm gonna start to tilt if you wanna get a shot of this. I don't think I used enough paint. It's just all gonna turn out red. Well, that didn't work out very good. So, let's try this. When in doubt, just follow what your heart tells you to do, I guess. I think first off, my paint is too thin. I should have made my paint thicker. You guys will have to critique me. See, it's going off that way. I need a couple stir sticks over here to put under this side. Or maybe just one. Now that's looking pretty cool. That's a lot of paint. Whoa, that's really cool looking. You could see it really starting to come off over the edges here. I'm thinking that's pretty cool right there. I don't know too much more what I should do. Maybe I should add a little bit of gold in the middle. You want to get a close-up shot of some of this flowing over the edge here? So that's pretty cool. I'm going to leave it right where it's at, and hopefully it won't run off too much and leave some of that same cool design effect in there. So that's my tree ring pour for today. I'll keep doing updates as we go along. So here is like a 5-minute update. It's only been just a few more minutes. This over here almost looks like it's gonna be like a gold heart or something. But I'm loving it. Not exactly what I had in mind. I better watch some more videos on tree ring pours. I don't know why this is so interesting and cool to me about watching the paint drip, but it's so calming and relaxing. Just a little ASMR for you. For those of you that don't know what ASMR is, you might want to look it up. Getting some really cool designs over here, too. Well, you can tell how much paint I used. A lot. It's totally burying these stir sticks over here. But I think I got the canvas level enough to where it will stay that way. Doesn't really look like a tree ring pour to me, but this is my first time, so I'm trying. Okay, here is 10 minutes later. Now you can really start to see the defining. Here's what the Floetrol does with the Liquitex pouring medium. It creates its own little designs, and I love it. This gold over here is really like swooshed through the red, the deep red magenta. I love it. Whether this was a total failure or not, I don't really believe in failures with painting. I believe you can always start over or whatever if you don't like it. So here's another 10 minutes later. You can really see the marbling starting to come out in that. And that's what I love about the Floetrol and the Liquitex pouring medium. You just can't make a mistake with it. You can't. There are no mistakes. There are no failures. I love this stuff. Look at this marbling over here. Beautiful. This is about another 20 minutes later, and check it out. This old gold metallic is really starting to marble. I love it so much. So what turned out to be a failure was not really a failure at all. That's what I love about this painting. You'll love it too. I know you can do this. I know anybody can do this. If I can do it, you can do it. Okay, that's it. Once it's dry, I'm going to go ahead and coat it with some Liquitex gloss varnish using this brush. And it's gonna look awesome. I want to thank you guys for watching. This has really turned out to be a learning experience.